Hi, and welcome to the Disability Awareness Training for State Employees, which is part of the Missouri as a Model Employer Initiative. So let's start out by asking, what is the Missouri as a Model Employer Initiative? Well, back on January 31st of 2019, Governor Parson announced an initiative to become a model employer and to support a diverse and expanded workforce. It was intended to help more people with disabilities obtain competitive, integrated employment within state government, thereby allowing us to become a model for private businesses and nonprofits. Becoming a model employer is crucial to ensuring Missouri is doing everything possible to fully integrate Missourians with disabilities into the workforce and to expand our pool of talented job candidates. So let's look at the learning objectives for this disability awareness training. First, we want to increase awareness on the value of a diverse workforce in state government. Next, we aim to create workplaces which embrace employees with and without disabilities. And lastly, we want to foster greater understanding about how we can be supportive coworkers and provide you with resources for information and assistance. So, why is it important that we talk about disability awareness within state government? Well, it's important to know that disability is the largest minority group in the world. Roughly 1 in 4 adults in the United States has a disability. Each one of us may experience a disability in our lifetime. Within this large group of people, the workforce participation rate is less than half the rate of those with no disability. With that information in mind, it's easy to see that there's work to be done. We also talk about disability awareness because we believe there are multiple benefits of a diverse and expanded workforce. We're able to draw upon a larger pool of talents and skills. Employees from different backgrounds can offer a wider variety of skills and solutions to achieve common goals. A diverse, expanded workforce can reduce hiring and training costs because it helps to reduce turnover. And lastly, a diverse and expanded workforce helps to improve productivity through innovative and effective ways of doing business. So let's talk about individuals with disabilities in the workplace. As state employees, we will all encounter coworkers and customers with disabilities. The Americans with Disabilities Act defines disability as a physical or mental impairment that substantially limits one or more major life activities. It also includes having a history or a record of an impairment or being perceived as having an impairment. Now, looking at that definition, there are a few items that are important to highlight. First, what is a physical or mental impairment? Well, it can include any physiological disorder or condition. It can be a cosmetic disfigurement. It could be an anatomical loss affecting one or more of a number of body systems. And it can be any mental or psychological disorder. Next, what is a major life activity? Major life activities are those functions that are important to most people's daily lives. Walking, seeing, hearing, thinking, reading, writing, as well as major bodily functions. Lastly, what is a record of impairment? It means that the person has a history of or has been classified as having a mental or physical impairment that substantially limits one or more major life activities, even though the person does not currently have a disability. For example, a person who undergoes treatment for cancer then returns to work. Although the cancer may be in remission, they have a record of having had it. There are some disabilities that are easy to recognize and others that are invisible, such as learning disabilities, asthma, diabetes, or mental health disorders. Some examples of mental health disorders include post-traumatic stress disorder, also known as PTSD, anxiety or panic disorders, and depression. In the next few slides, let's go over general etiquette tips for interacting with an individual with disabilities. First off, always use person-first language when speaking to or about an individual with disabilities. For example, a man who has autism, a woman who has depression, a child who has a learning disability, or a person who uses an interpreter. Before you provide assistance to an individual, always ask first and wait for the person's response before you help. If it isn't important to the conversation, don't mention the disability at all. After all, you wouldn't say, "My coworker, who's in his 50s and has brown hair." Use appropriate terms such as person with a disability or wheelchair user who needs accessible parking, and stay away from negative or disrespectful terms like confined to or suffering from. Now let's look at a few more specialized situations. Etiquette for wheelchair users. pull up a chair to place yourself at eye level to avoid forcing the person to look up for an extended period of time. Avoid touching the wheelchair. It's considered his or her personal space. Don't assume the individual can't see, hear, or isn't intelligent, and keep floor spaces and paths clear. Communicating with team members who are deaf or hard of hearing. If they are using an interpreter, speak to the person directly and not to the interpreter. Face the person when speaking. Speak slowly and clearly, and don't chew gum or place your hands in front of your mouth. Also, keep in mind to take turns speaking when in groups. Communicating by phone with an employee who's deaf or hard of hearing. The person may be using an assistive listening device or an amplified phone. Please speak slowly and clearly. If the person is using an interpreter, address the person when speaking, not the relay interpreter who will type the information for the individual. Allow time for the transcript and reading. For example, don't say, "tell him" or "tell her." Instead, speak to the individual directly. To make a call to a TTY user, call Missouri Relay at 711. Then provide the phone number of the individual to be called. This is a free service. Video relay calling is a newer technology and requires the individual to have a phone with a display screen and an internet connection. The interpreter will provide American Sign Language interpretation on a video screen rather than typing the information. Additional tips for communicating with coworkers with speech or hearing impairments. Make sure you allow enough time for a person with a speech impairment to speak, and repeat what you heard to check for understanding. Familiarize yourself with alternate forms of communication, or use pen and paper if necessary. Interacting with coworkers who are blind or visually impaired. Introduce yourself when entering a room and make the person aware when you're leaving the room. Be descriptive and specific when giving directions. If the person needs assistance, offer them to take your elbow to guide them. Don't guide a person who is blind or visually impaired up or down stairs. Instead, guide them to the handrail and tell them how many stairs there are. At the workplace, make screen readers, magnifiers, and other assistive technology available. Interacting with employees who use a service dog. A service dog is a dog that is individually trained to do work or perform tasks for a person with a disability. Service animals are allowed in places open to the public, such as government buildings, restaurants, libraries, doctor's offices, movie theaters, grocery stores, etc. A person using a service animal may or may not appear to have a disability. If a coworker or customer is using a service dog, keep in mind that a service animal is not a pet. It's performing work and should not be touched unless the handler gives their permission. Do not distract the service animal from doing its job by offering food or water, talking to it, or making noises directed at it. Recognize the dog and the person with a disability as a team. Mental health conditions. It's important to know that they are common. In any given year, nearly 20% of U.S. adults have a mental health condition, and over 50% will manage a condition at some point in their lives. We are more likely to experience a mental health condition than cancer, heart disease, or diabetes combined. Knowing this, learn and share the facts about mental health. Treat people with respect and dignity. Avoid labeling people by their diagnosis, and provide support when you can. Let's watch this short video to go over what we've just learned.
Good morning, Bob.
Morning there, big man. Morning, Alice!
There's no need to be awkward.
Poor Bob. Like so many of us, he just doesn't know how to interact with people with disabilities.
It's pretty easy, really. People with disabilities are people first.
We need the same things that every person needs, like respect.
Good morning, everyone.
Attention! Okay. Maybe we need to be more specific.
The easiest way to show respect is to focus on the person, not the disability. It's okay. You'll get the hang of it.
One easy way to focus on the person is to watch the person signing and not their interpreter.
Or their companion.
It's really cool that you'd like to help, but do us both a favor and please ask me first. What you think might be helping?
I got you.
Wait, ah! Oh no, might actually not.
If you'd like to offer me help, let me hold on to your elbow. Don't take mine.
Hey, would you like to take my arm?
Sure.
Assistive devices help us to live our lives. They're really important and really personal.
Grabbing them only makes it weird for everyone.
What?
Please only touch our devices and service animals if we've given you permission. And don't take it personally if I ask you not to. Remember that my service animal helps me all the time. Neither of us would like it if we were separated.
Remember, we make our own decisions. We sign documents, vote, volunteer, work, and pay taxes.
We get married.
So don't address me just because I have a great smile.
Just because I'm blind.
May I help you?
Does not mean I'm deaf.
Just because I'm deaf doesn't mean I'm blind.
And just because I use a wheelchair doesn't mean that I can't sweep you off your feet.
So take a deep breath, relax. We don't bite.
Unless we're really hungry.
Hello there, ladies, how are you?
Hello.
And if you're not sure what to do, just ask.
Hi, would you still like to see a menu?
No thanks, but can you please read it to me?
Sure, definitely.
Just treat us the way you would want to be treated, and we'll all be okay.
Good morning.
Good morning.
Good morning, Alice.
Morning.
Awkward no more. Nice job, Bob. Go forth and be human.
There's no need to be awkward.
So, where can state employees get more information or assistance? For general questions about disability issues, you may contact the Governor's Council on Disability at 573-751-2600 or gcd@oa.mo.gov. If you're experiencing a disability and would like to request a workplace accommodation, please contact your agency's ADA coordinator in your Human Resources office. If you or someone you know would like more information about state employment opportunities for Missourians with disabilities, contact the Division of Personnel at recruiter@oa.mo.gov. Congratulations! This concludes the Disability Awareness Training.